Good evening. Thank you for being here to join me in celebrating wonderful music for the pipe organ played on this iconic instrument in this glorious acoustic. Knowing that, we can all appreciate better what we are hearing if we know something about the pieces. I'll take just a minute to walk through the remaining pieces on tonight's program. J.S. Bach hardly needs an introduction to a group of organ enthusiasts. His music defines great organ music, and this is one of his most dramatic fantasias and one of his most fun and even happy fugues, even for being in a minor key. Every other piece on tonight's program is programmatic in some way, meaning that it is associated with a thought, an idea, a scripture, a hymn tune in some way. I have my notes here just to make sure I don't forget something that I'm doing. The next piece by Franz Tunder. Tunder is roughly in between the time of Buxtehude, whom Tunder succeeded in his post in northern Germany, and then J.S. Bach. So this is mid to late Baroque music. It is a choral prelude in three movements on the Lutheran hymn, Jesus Christ, Our Savior, Turned God's Wrath from Us. It is angular writing, as one would expect from a title that talks about God's wrath and turning that wrath from us. It is in, as I said, three movements. The first movement features double pedal. The tune is in the upper of the two pedal parts. You'll hear the tune most clearly in the second, quieter movement of that piece. Following the Tunder, we will hear a very different work by the living American composer Mark C. Jones. This is a setting of the beloved Protestant hymn, My Faith Looks Up to Thee. First verse reads, My faith looks up to thee, thou Lamb of Calvary, Savior divine. Now hear me while I pray. Take all my guilt away. Oh, let me from this day be wholly thine. It is a simple, quiet, but very effective setting of this beloved hymn tune. We will next turn to the music of two 20th century British composers. Herbert Howells is the first, wrote much important music, ecclesiastical music for choir and organ, several Psalm-Preludes. This particular Psalm-Prelude is based on Psalm 33, verse 3, sing unto the Lord a new song, play skillfully with a loud noise. Well, we know what instrument plays loudly, and that's the organ. So it will be loud at the beginning and at the end. It's a great exuberant setting of this psalm, very symphonic and expansive in its scope. It's almost jaunty in its energy that it has. It'll be followed by a very different kind of piece written by Kenneth Leighton, another 20th century British composer who spent most of his life teaching and composing in Scotland. This is going to be the most dissonant piece on the program. It's always good to have a little heads up for that. You could be tempted to think that it is the movie scoring for some creepy science fiction movie or something like that, but it is not. This piece comes from his organ mass and is the fifth movement, the Agnus Dei, Lamb of God who taketh away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God who takes away the sins of the world, grant us peace. When I play this, I'm imagining a soul, a tormented soul, searching for the peace, strength, and power that comes through the atoning grace of Jesus Christ, the atoning power of Jesus Christ. This would be a Paul or a Alma the Younger or any of us in our extremity, searching for and pleading for peace from Christ. That peace in this music does not come until the very last chord, but when it comes, it is a glorious moment. Then, the music of César Franck. We are in his 200th year, celebrating that. The piece Héroïque is one of his iconic works. This work is the one piece on this program that is not associated with religious music in any way. It was written for the Trocadero Palace for a World's Fair event. But piece Héroïque partakes of the spirit of heroism, of the underdog working against all odds and coming out on top, perhaps born out of the revolutionary spirit of France. We could look at this as a sinner working towards salvation or looking toward fighting against something that keeps us down and looking for triumph at the end. Very triumphant music. Writing from Franck at the end of this piece. It would be a good way to end the program. It's hard to top the last page of Pièce, Héroïque, but Duruflè does a good job, which will be the actual final piece for tonight. Maurice Duruflè, important and influential 20th century French composer who wrote very much in a 19th century romantic style. This is his Opus 4, three movements on Veni Creator Spiritus, come Holy Spirit, descend upon us, a representation of the day of Pentecost. Thank you for being here tonight. For this program, please enjoy this wonderfully exciting and dramatic music played in this glorious space on this wonderful instrument. Thank you. it's fine to mention now. Let's go ahead and hold the applause until the very end of everything, and then all the music can flow along from one to the other. Thank you very much.